qi can't be fully reduced to bioelectricity, but bioelectricity is no doubt a modern way of talking about some of the phenomena that the Chinese have attributed to qi since ancient times. Previously underappreciated, modern research is continuing to shed light on just how important bioelectricity is. It's not just used in our brains and nervous systems. Cells throughout the entire body use it to communicate and even exhibit similar phenomena to the brain but on slower time scales. DNA isn't enough to determine how we are built, but rather just produces cellular hardware that is then implemented by aspects of our physiology like bioelectricity. Bioelectricity gives our body a sort of energetic memory that is held within the communities of cells that form electric networks throughout the body. Michael Levin, a well-known researcher in this field, calls bioelectricity the cognitive glue that ties our cells together. Our body is a living universe of intelligent cell communities communicating and coordinating various biological goals using the medium of bioelectricity. It's hard not to be reminded of the holistic views of classical Chinese medicine and the many overlapping metaphors Taoists have for the body, such as the body as a microcosmic landscape, or even as an administrative system paralleling the bureaucratic systems found at the levels of society. One amazing finding coming out of Michael Levin's bioelectricity research is the role of bioelectricity in cancer. An optimal state for a cell is for it to be in bioelectric communication with its neighbors. Cancer happens when that bioelectric communication breaks down. It is essentially what happens when a cell disconnects from the collective mind meld of cells working together towards healthy goals in the body and decides to rather treat its neighbors as a mere external environment for its own selfish exploitation. Amazingly, Levin showed in experiments with tadpoles that if you forced cancer cells back into electrical communication with their neighbors, carcinogenic tumors stopped growing. There is still so much that we don't know about bioelectricity and also about how it directly relates to practices like Neigong or meditation. Yet energetic flows, pulses, activations, whether bioelectric or other, is something that advanced practitioners of the internal arts can palpably feel and even control to various extents. An accumulation of ample stores of energy, for lack of a better term, and is used to unobstruct and integrate harmonious flows and communications throughout the body's many subsystems has been a primary facet of internal arts practice for a long time.